Well, welcome back. This is Falomi again, playing Guild Wars 2. Last episode, I left you at level 44. In that time, I got to level 45. Didn't record that part, didn't have the time, but I did want to finish the daily for the event completer in Metrica Province. So I did, and with that I gained level 45, so that's where we're gonna continue. The Wayfarer Foothills is the event for today, but I'm going somewhere else. I'm going back to Kessex Hills, because we got some completing to do. So let's move right up here, into Kessex Hills. Let's move up into the Harati Highlands part. And let's go get ourselves the first heart that we see. And that's the one that's right above us. Let's go. Find out if we can manage to do something today, to finish something. Would be nice. Should of course stayed in the Maguma jungle for the foraging effect. Didn't, so might be going back. Silly of me to forget that. Just to get back into the thick of things. Just helping to destroy something with some of the other characters around here. There were parts where you could jump up through the spikes here. Now this is one of those spots. And then you don't have to move back anywhere else. I can probably destroy this siege engine as well. There we go. And now other people that run by here don't get killed by the siege engine. Here. Gumo sapling. Well, let's get the tree then. Getting nuts for the tree. Very nice. And this one respawns as well, just while we're here. This all gives you experience, all of these destructions of catapults give you more and more experience towards this quest. I am being targeted by one. And where is it actually? Oh, it's right in there. Gotta go touch that. I can of course get this Harati flag. And there's another one at the back here as well. And it's destroyed. There we go. Centaur dwelling can also be destroyed, I see. hard thing to hit. It's a big dwelling, but can't seem to be hitting it. There we go. The dwelling is destroyed. Nicely done. Now to get out of here. Move right down here.
Oh, I can't wait to explore this place.
Nope, me neither. This moves into a small town where I can extinguish some fires. It seems like someone is stuck in the wall. Nice. Well done. And there is a waypoint here, which I would like to have. A waypoint that leads to the area next door, which is back into the Brisbane Wildlands, it seems. Now what I need to do here is find traps, and the traps are in the moat here. They are actually hard to find on my screen. Well, here's one. Here's another one. Not so hard to find if the area is in a sunny place, so to speak. But in the shadows, it's hard to see. Might be because of the light that I have coming in from outside. Not gonna change that right now. Well, there's also some fires going on here. As you can see, the bush is on fire here. And there are some water buckets here that you can use to extinguish these fires. And that also gives experience towards this this quest. And the explosive shots, of course. This particular one, you don't need to refill your bucket constantly, which is quite nice. It's weird and it's nice. Gotta have some water in order to in order to put some out, but hey, it doesn't seem to be the case. Gathering the toxic spores. In some of them, there's the pristine spore samples. Most of them aren't. No more fires to put out. These taproots look interesting. Let me get those. And after that, I can deposit a whole lot of these things. I can also open up Black Lion chest if I want to, because I got the key. Well, I say go for it. Let's see what we get. Well, I think I got some great items. Double click to gain a buff that regenerates health for 1 hour. Well, we don't really need that right now. My bag is starting to be filled up quite a bit. This is 100% chance of recovering upgrades and 50% chance to do that. This is a very, very good bag. I want to keep this one as long as possible. This is the one that's going to upgrade my weapons. Probably am going to need a bag soon, just because I have too many things that I already have in my inventory. Well, I can at least use my food now, because the timer has worked out. Is gone, is out. Alright, let's see. The fires here are gone. I can battle centaurs and disarm traps, which I was already doing. Damage assaults. Well, these traps are already gone. They do respawn, but it takes some time. So I'm not gonna wait for that. I'm just going to try to find some more centaurs. If I can find some more centaurs, then that's going to be easier to do. Scrap, that's also good. Are you going to take on another one? No, you're not? Okay, well. Pleasure doing business with you. I'm too far away from these, Harati. These don't count. At least this one doesn't count. Need to move back into the questing area. Let's see if I can, and how much further I need to move back. That's a whole lot, even. I probably can get this one. Yes, I can. This one does not count. This one does not count. That's quite annoying. Well, you can jump up here, it seems. Let's give that a try. Some bears. A Rati sharpshooter up there as well. Ah, also spike trap. Good. And another one. Okay, so on this side there are a few spike traps that are left. The bear is dead. Does it hold more? There's at least a Rati Trampler that's going to add to the experience, and some onions, and I want the onions, of course. For my cooking business. Being on this side is even too far away for the quest. It's really a very small area. Let's see if some of the spike traps are respawned. ...107 extra experience. Well, that's nice, just for killing a bear. The bear itself doesn't give you much experience, but the added effect of the added experience is very nice. Here's a spike trap. Bushes don't seem to be on fire yet. Another spike trap. And another spike trap. Good. At least they do light up when you move close to them. That's at least nice. There's nothing over here. No dungeon, no nothing. So let's not move over there. Let's try and go down a little bit. And see if we can find some more spike traps over here. which we can't. I think there were a few that were respawned, but not all of them. So just have to keep waiting for respawning of the spike traps, or here's one, very nice. Or I have to find some more of these Harati warriors. This one. This is one that was too far away. Is he too far away? No, he's not too far away. That's nice to see. Different parts of the quest give you different pieces of experience, different amounts of experience, and the experience you get for spike traps isn't very high. The Harati traplus is higher, but then you do have to find a few of those, of course. Almost forgot to pick the point of interest here. And I'm right on top of it, so that would be silly of me if I didn't. Let's sell all the junk we got. Got quite a lot. Open up the bags and salvage the leather scrap. There we go. That saves up some bag space, which we're going to be needing. Alright. Spike traps. There's one. I saw that one. I see this one. And I see this one. That's nice. Cleaned up three more. Ooh, another one. And that got us the amount we needed to finish this quest. Very nice. Another one silver 24. Added to the amount we already have. Now to go into this town. Well, there's not much to do in this town. It does have some nice coats. All of these things are worse than the things I have already, so
that is all.
Not really interested in this. We already have the vista and the waypoint here. So what we're going to do now is move towards Thunder Ridge, where we were doing the quest. Let's pick up the point of interest and let's move over the bridge. Very nice skill, that save yourselves. Gives you a lot of boons at once. I think this quest is going to be finished just before I get here. No, I'm not. Well, at least I'm going to get some experience in some kill in. Well, no, I was too late. That was a shame. Okay. Didn't get to jump in on that event fast enough. Can't jump up here. Yeah, there we go. Else we would have gotten a nice amount of experience just for putting in some damage. Would have been nice. Couldn't do it. Let's go up here. Over the bridge, to the other side. Well, not over the bridge then. Bridge is still broken. Let's move through the water. Water doesn't... doesn't draw you in and move you through its spaces. These serif badges can be turned in. Stalks are traveled into the ground and then you get experience for them. And I see some tap roots that I want, and another badge that I want. This bandit cut purse is in the way. The one thing that I should not be doing is move into this area with the red circle around it. Moving into that area is certain death. Well, almost certain death. At least for me, it's almost certain death. It's a very annoying plant that stands over there, and it's very powerful. It does a lot of damage. Tough tree. It's not really the tree that does a lot of damage, but the poison effect next to it is very annoying. And that causes a lot of damage. Golden Moa just standing around there, doing nothing. Air purifier location, it also is poisoned here. Well, can't do that without an air purifier. So that's one of the annoying parts about this area. It has some strong poison in it. What was that? Someone dropped something down. I don't like the sound of that. Well, at least I was out of that area fast enough. There is a waypoint here. Let's pick that one up. I also need to turn in my badges at the quest giver. Well, at least now we have something we can fall back on. Three badges, not that much. Doesn't have a point of interest. So just going back out into this area, and let's see if we can find some more of these immature stalks. And badges, of course. This is the quest giver. He has the air purifiers here as well. I can always try to use an air purifier at a location. And we know that the location is right over there. I don't know what it's actually going to do, but let's purify the air here. We placed it. And a hallucination comes out of this area. And he poisons. And the hallucination is gone. The toxic stalk next to it can also be destroyed now. That was the one that we already had the last time, but it probably respawned already. Another badge piece. Now I'm almost at the end of this quest. So the last thing that I do should be turning in the badges, because that clears out my my inventory and gives me the quest. So there's two things at once. That would be the nicest thing. Let's get one more of these stalks, and I see one right here. That did not clear the quest, and but I do have two badges with me, so let's go back to the quest giver. Give him the badges that I already have. Let's see if that finishes this quest. If it gives me enough experience. And it did. Very nice. What do you have? Do you have anything that can help me? No. Not at all. Not even junk that I can sell. There is a point of interest that is lighting up. So right on the other end, at a piece of an area of the area that looks like some sort of dock area. Well, let's move down there then. 120 and another 240 in. I don't want to move into the toxic cloud back there. Another 240 in karma. Karma's gonna help me again. I do want to finish this area. I just want to get out of here with everything done, so I don't have to go back here. Probably because I already finished the quest, all the toxic purifiers are working now. Yes, there we go. Now I need to go back down here. Can I do that swimming style? I probably can. Well, let's just try it. Because it's going to save time if I do. Well, there's one of the brackish that's already following me out here.
Now, this is a mine.
Getting two things at once. Can get up here fast enough that I want to be in on this beating the toxic alchemist. It seems I can, so a lot of help here. Didn't expect there to be this many people on this fight. I don't think I ever did this fight. Maybe I did, but I can't remember. It's one of the things that I try to avoid if I can. Can't seem to click the toxic one. There we go. There we go, that's gold. And 2200 in experience, that's pretty good. Probably getting some nice stuff here. Well, I did. I think it's the first time I'm actually killing one of these toxic fellas. Seen them before, but never went into to actually help and kill them. 373 with toughness and vitality in the staff, and not with precision. This one is not going to be good enough. It's going to give me a nice little bit more. And silver. And we have the scepter, and the scepter is actually quite nice. Very nice indeed. Power and ferocity. 332. I'm going to see what my sword actually has right now. I wanted to have a scepter as a second weapon, because I don't really like the second weapon I have right now. I don't like the staff that much. The sword is 335. Well, it's actually the same. Yep, it's actually the same. Well, this is very nice. I'm going to put it right there, and I'm going to get the heck out of here. Oh. I need to be down in the water and find the place where I can swim into the cave. Because there's a cave system here that allows you to pick up the point of interest right down there. Very slow weapon. Faster. Let's get some experience as well from the shark now that we're at it. I believe that there is a cave system somewhere down here, and I don't know which side it was on, but there is a cave system here. Not over here. It was either down or up. Ah, it's probably over here somewhere. Must be over here somewhere. Why are you attacking me, Mr. Shark? Small scales. What do we got from the shark? Let's wait for that. Well, this is the side where the Quaggan are on. I would think that this is also the side where the cave is at, but it seems that there's not a cave in sight. So where is it? I know it's here somewhere. Or was it even further to the other side? It could also be that there was on the other side of the... on the other side of this mountain. Down below, somewhere more south. And it's a long cave, and the point of interest is actually at the back. Could also be the case. Well, it doesn't seem to be over here. Blood Witch quest is actually quite hard. Veteran Toxic Deimos and a Vista that I want. That gives me the Vista. And I think the Toxic... yeah. The Blood Witch is right in there. Well, let's not move in there. Let's not go there. As you know, I hate fighting on the water, so let's not do it right now. Didn't find a point of interest yet. That's quite annoying. But I am getting out of the water. Ah, there is another point of interest there. It's right where the Blood Witch is at. Another black lion chest. Set of new boots.
6 feet tall.
Set of new boots, set of new pants, that's what I wanted to say. Rune of the Afflicted, when the foes with less than 50% health. Well, it doesn't really matter, it gives me more power and it gives me precision. So yeah, I do want to have those pants on. I can't really tell you why I'm down here. So this must be one of the most difficult areas in the game. for me at least at this moment, from what I see. Yeah, well, it got me the point of interest. That is something that I wanted to have. And this toxic Deimos seems to be respawning constantly. Not making things easier. At all. One rag. Keeps respawning. It's very annoying. I'm not going in there. I do want to go back here. Kill Quagan predators and collect tasty crab meat for Doyle. No, that's something. Probably a bad idea for me to actually go in and help the guys fight the Blood Witch. If I do that and I actually get killed there, then I'm not gonna forgive myself. Would make a very silly death. Well, this is the Quagan village again. These crabs probably give the crab meat that you need for whatever Do Something wants to do. What's his name? Dulcileep. There's a clam. Probably gives you clam meat. Very nice. Dulcileep is right over there. And this is the hermit crab that I want to grab hold of. The group that stayed behind to kill the Blood Witch is actually doing a very good job. Temptation is really high to go in there, but it's already too late now. There's nothing left for me to do. If I move up there, then probably they're gonna finish the event already. Crab trap. Let's open that one up. Well, this is going to almost end the episode as well. I think I am going to end it. R- life is going to kick in soon. I need to grab meat. Don't let me not get the crab meat, of course. That would be silly if I do not get crab meat. Working the trap also gives you the experience you need for the quest. Hope I get to finish this one right now. Seems that I am. So I'm going to give this these few pieces to Dulcileep and hope that I get towards where I want to be. There we go. Yes, we did. We helped the Quagan. We got the thing done that we wanted to do. Got some stuff left that I need to sell. Instantly, and this one is soulbound. And if it's soulbound, then Dulcileep is probably going to accept it. So that helped. It gave me a shield. That's actually something that I can use with my scepter right now, because I don't have anything else. So let's put those two together. And now let's move to a safe spot. Grave camp is probably going to be somewhat safe. Maybe if there's going to be events here, then I'm going to be in the middle of an event, but not right now, so that actually finishes my episode right now. I'd like to thank you all for watching. This was a part of Kessex Hills that we completed this episode. Done a few of the hard quests, went into a few events even, and got a little bit further into finishing Kessex Hills. We're at 50% right now, and the next episode we're gonna try to complete it a little bit further. This was Falumi playing Guild Wars 2. If you like this episode, please press the like button. If you'd like to see more of these episodes, please follow the stream, so you'll be updated once there is a new episode up. Thanks again.